like to do an overview and offer some tips and tricks about getting around the Windows 8 interface. To begin with, you can see that we have the tile interface that has become synonymous with Windows 8. Some of these tiles are what we call live tiles, so you'll see them periodically updating. Sometimes you may not want that, so one trick is if I press and hold one of the tiles, there's an option down in the settings bar that I can come up and it says turn live tile off. So if I do that, that will just bring up the icon and you won't see anything rotating through. You might want to do that particularly with your mail app because you don't want, perhaps if you're taping, you may not want everybody to see your emails popping up there. So you can turn live tiles on and off. We're in customize mode right now. So to get out of customize mode, I need to touch in some other area of the screen, the blank screen. Another new feature of Windows 8.1, and this is 8.1 running on the original Surface RT, is if I press and hold one of the tiles, again, it brings up the customize menu. You can actually resize the tiles. So right now, I prefer the desktop to be the largest size possible, but let's say we want to go to medium. So whenever I do that, you can see that it automatically resizes, all of the other tiles adjust. Now let me change that back, so let me press and touch. You see the selection box. I want to go back to large. Now you have complete flexibility. You can have as many tiles as you would like or as few of tiles as you would like. So I'm in customize mode again. Let me show you one other one. Let's just go here to maps, select that, and go to resize and show you the smallest size. So they've gone from very small, medium, the wide tile, and then the large style tile. Click off once again. Now, as I said, you don't have to have all of these tiles out there. For example, let's say I don't want to have games. So if I select that, I can do what is called unpin from the start menu. So when I do that, it goes away. So the games tile is no longer available to me. However, I didn't uninstall it, it's still available on this device. So if I slide up, I'm in customize mode. So once again, I've got to press to get off of it. When I slide up, it brings me to all of my apps. And if you look through here is the games tile. So if I want to, I can press, select that, and say pin to start. When I pin to start, it automatically appends to the right-hand side of your tile screen, your start screen here. So just some tricks getting around. Let me go back up to all apps. If you're having trouble finding something, you can sort them. You can sort them by name, by date installed, which is kind of handy if you're going to the store. It automatically puts them in the all apps folder. It doesn't automatically pin them anymore to the start screen in Windows 8.1. Most used, or you can sort by category. All right. Now if I swipe back down to get to my start screen, let me show you a couple other ways to navigate around the start screen. Windows uses what is called the start screen to kind of be home base, and you'll notice that there is a flag on the tablet. Let me go to desktop. So if I press this desktop tile, and if I press the Windows flag on the tablet, that automatically takes me back to the start screen. Desktop, press the Windows flag, it takes me back. If I press the Windows flag again, it takes me to the last application that I have open, and the desktop is considered an application. Another way to get around is, since I have the keyboard attached, I can press the Windows flag keyboard and it does the same thing. Press the Windows key again, it takes me back to the last app, again the desktop. A third way to get around, since this is Windows 8.1, they have put back the Windows flag in the lower left-hand corner that everybody's familiar with, the start button in Windows. So if I press that Windows flag, that will automatically take me back to the start screen. And then finally, a fourth way, if you think of Windows interface as an Edge UI, an Edge user interface, if you imagine a one pixel border all the way around the outside edge of the bezel. So whenever you break the plane of that one pixel border, it will bring up different functions. So if I come over here and press or swipe in with my thumb, that brings up what is called the charms bar. So I can search, share, start, devices, or settings. Let me click off of that. So just swiping in, just barely breaking that border, that brings up the charms bar. If I swipe in from the left-hand side and I hold this in portrait mode, this is a very natural position. If I swipe in with my thumb from the left-hand side, that brings up the application. So I'm just going to swipe through. I have several apps already open here. So you can see how quick you can switch between different apps. All right, so I'm back to the desktop. Now, if I swipe in from the left-hand side about a half inch and pull it back, that puts me into task view so I can see all of the open apps that I have. And if I want to very quickly jump to a specific app, let's just go to the podcast app. I can go there. Let me slide that in about a half inch, bring it back, and let's go to sports. So I can very quickly target and go to exactly the app that I want to do. However, it is so fast anymore that it's just as easy to cycle through whenever you have a half dozen or so apps already open. To close an app, you drag down from the top. So I'm going to start off the border here, the bezel, drag down and pull it all the way down to the bottom, and that closes in the app. So you can see that sports is no longer available here. Another way that I can do it is, here's the finance app. If it's not open, I can drag it over here and then drag it down, and that closes the app. So I've got my podcast. Let's just drag it down and close it out. Okay, I'm back to my start screen. Now, if I want to do a quick search, you just saw the search menu pop up. I can come up here, type in search, whatever it is. And this is context sensitive, so whatever I'm in. If I'm in games and I go to search, it will search for the different games. But the other thing that not many know, on the start screen, since I have the keyboard, if I just start typing, if I'm looking for an app and I can't find it, say I want to open up Word, I can just simply start typing anywhere, anytime the start screen's available, W-O-R-D, and it will go out and do a search for me. And you can see the top choice here is Word 2013. So if I select that, it will go to the desktop and automatically open up Word. Okay? So the other thing, let me just close Word out here. Let's go back to the start screen. So I'm going to press my Windows flag key on the keyboard here. Since I have the keyboard available here, let me just snap this off. It's very easy to snap on and off. It's a magnetic catch. So if I want to put it back on, it snaps on very easily. But let's say I'm done with this. Let's come back here and hold this in normal portrait mode. I also use the kickstand quite a bit. Once you use a tablet with a kickstand, you'll be lost without it. So that's a very handy feature. But once I have something open, as I said, I can come through. Now the desktop is considered an app, so you can also, once you save all of your work, you can drag it down and close it out. So now then, close that back out. I have nothing available until I open the desktop again. Close it out and cycle through. So now then you see that I have nothing open except the start screen available here. One last tip, if you're arranging things in groups, if you pinch down to minimize this start area, this makes it handy to organize things by groups. So here's the office group. If for some reason I want to have that go all the way over on the right hand side, I can move it, zoom it back out, and you'll see that my office group is clear over here. However, just convenient, the apps that you use the most, you probably want to put over here on the left hand side of the screen, just because of the way that Office 8 is set up to scroll off to the right. So my most used apps, I generally keep right here on the main page, and then I can scroll over and go to whatever app it is. If I want to open up, let's go back over here to the Bing apps again, open up Finance. It'll go out here. Let's just go out here and open something else up so I can cycle through. Let's open up the Weather app. So I haven't opened this one up today. So it'll go out, go to the internet. This is yesterday, it was quite cold here, and it will do an update. So we went from 31, it's even colder this morning, 20 degrees Fahrenheit currently. So winter is coming. All right, as I said, I can cycle through all the different apps. Whenever I finish with one, drag it down and close it, bring me over into task view, drag this out and close it. And then one final thing, let me show you the snap feature. I can come out here, let's open up the finance app. Let's go over here and open up the weather app. So now then I have finance and weather both open. So I can bring finance out and we can do something called snap. So I'm going to let go here, and this will do a 50-50 snap. So, you know, I can actually do it a little bit different way. This is the RT. Depending upon the resolution of your monitor, you may be able to get three or four snaps out here. This is the Surface RT, which is a little bit lower resolution. So whenever you're finished with that, you can just slide that off. Now the app is still open. Here's my weather app. So once again, I can just slide through in full screen view. When I'm finished, close it out. I'm up here, finished, close it out, and we'll wrap it up right here.